Philippine Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos recommends the relief of cops based in a police substation near a raided pogo hub in Pasay City. Abalos also wants the chief of the Pasay City Police to be investigated for alleged inaction. During last Friday's raid on the unlicensed gaming hub, over 700 workers were apprehended, with some claiming they were forced to work against their will. Police say these workers also offered illicit services.
Ang sa akin lang kamukha ng sinabi ko, napakalapit. That's why I'm asking for investigation of the chief of police. At the same time as the NAPOLCOM chairperson, I was recommending to the chief PNP na yung substation commander and all of the members be relieved pending investigation. This is human trafficking Hindi biro ito ha. Sa nakita mga kwarto at sa nakikita pa ngayon, ganong kagrabe ito And let this be a lesson to everyone.
Several Philippine senators have been calling for a total ban on pogo, citing criminal activities linked to the industry. Well, it's been 2 days since the voting for the village and youth council polls wrapped up in the country. But for residents in a village in Samar, the voting process is still ongoing. Victoria Tula now joins us to tell us why. Victoria, go ahead.
That's correct, Carmina. 2 days after the October 30 village and youth council polls, Nag-Uma Village in Calbayog City, Samar, is just holding elections today after incidents of harassment. The Commission on Elections reported Tuesday that the contingent delivering election paraphernalia to Nag-Uma and Binawakan Village was fired upon by an insurgent group, which halted the delivery and suspended voting on Monday. Binawakan was able to conduct elections and proclaim vote winners on Tuesday, but Nag-Uma was not. Attorney John Rex Claudianco, COMELEC spokesperson, said the election team and its escorts proceeded to Nag-Uma yesterday but were met by a private armed group which fired at them. The election officers and electoral board members were kept safe by the Philippine Army, who neutralized 5 members of the private armed group. The COMELEC contingent took shelter in the nearest village and stayed the night. This morning, they were able to proceed to Nag-Uma, where voting began at 7:45 a.m. Because of the shooting incidents, Nag-Uma is the only remaining village where voting is still ongoing. As for Bayang Lanao del Sur, where voting was also delayed, and 5 villages, due to the late delivery of election paraphernalia on Monday, COMELEC says all villages are done with canvassing. We are still awaiting the latest figures on the total number of winners proclaimed. As of 9:57 last night, 99.75% of villages have proclaimed victors in the village and youth council polls.
Bulacan residents vote no to converting San Jose del Monte into a highly urbanized city. The plebiscite was held October 30, the same day the village and youth council polls were conducted. Around 820,000 voted no, while 620,000 voted yes. San Jose del Monte is the largest city in Bulacan and had met the minimum requirements to be classified as a highly urbanized city, which would have given it autonomy from the provincial government. Well, millions of Filipinos are paying their dearly departed a visit in cemeteries across the country this All Saints Day. President Marcos visited his father, the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr., at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani. Katrina Domingo now joins us with that story. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and his family spent All Saints Day at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani in Taguig City, where the remains of their patriarch lay rest since 2016. Aside from the president, among those who attended the mass in honor of the Marcos patriarch, Ferdinand Marcos Sr., are First Lady Liza Marcos and their sons, Simon and Vincent, as well as Marcos family matriarch and former First Lady Imelda Marcos. And the president's sisters were also there, particularly Senator Amy Marcos and Irene Marcos Araneta. The president did not grant interviews after the mass at the Hero Cemetery, but in his official Undas message this year, the president reminded the public that these holidays are meant to honor the dead, and they also come as a refreshing gift so that we can enjoy reuniting with our loved ones while also receiving much-needed nourishment for our spiritual lives. The president also reminded the public to reflect on the purpose and our unceasing need for God's guidance during the holidays that celebrate the saints' staunch devotion and the legacies of those who have gone before us. Now, meantime, Carmina, Vice President Sara Duterte also released her own All Saints Day message, telling the public that the All Saints Day and the All Souls Day holidays are opportunities for the nation to reflect on their faith and ask the Almighty for the continued blessing of strength and healing as a nation. She also asked the public to pray for the country's protection against calamities, disasters, wars, and forces that may threaten our unity and cause human suffering.
We're going to go over now to the Manila Memorial Park, where Jervis Manahan is standing by with an update. Jervis, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, the weather is pretty bad here at the Manila Memorial Park in Paranaque, but the rain is not stopping visitors from flocking to the cemetery. As of 11 a.m., 33,000 visitors have entered the Memorial Park. Flow of traffic is moderate to heavy inside the cemetery as it is open for vehicles. There are parking spaces allotted inside, but they are on a first-come, first-served basis. Park management said more than 102,000 visitors were recorded yesterday, and a lot of them stayed overnight at the Memorial Park. They are expecting more than 200,000 visitors today, but the number may change because of the inclement weather. Some Salesian nuns visited the tombs of the departed members of the Aquino family. President Bongbong Marcos also sent white flowers for the Aquinos today. No untoward incident has been recorded so far, and there are very few prohibited items confiscated at the gates. Phone signal is relatively weak because of the volume of people inside. A locator booth is also set up for those who might get lost. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Jervis Manahan, there joining us live. Well, Cebuanos also flocking to cemeteries in the province to visit their dead. Annie Pedestal joins us with the latest from there. Annie, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, we're here in one of the larger cemeteries in Cebu City, Careta Public Cemetery. And so far, authorities say that everything is peaceful and in order. However, there are still those who are making last-minute cleaning and beautification based on the guidelines released by the cemetery and the Philippine National Police. This shouldn't be allowed. They're only giving them until 3 p.m. to complete everything, the cleaning and everything that has to be done to the tombs. Earlier, the director of the Cebu City Police Office, Colonel Ireneo Dalugdog, made his rounds to conduct assessments in the cemeteries. Except for a few senior citizens that painted and illegal vendors that were able to get in but then were escorted out, he says that their security plan is going as expected. The crowd isn't as much as it was last year, the Dalugdog spokesperson, Police Lieutenant Colonel Janet Rafter says. It could possibly be due to the long weekend where the crowd is already dispersed over the past days. People continue to flock the cemetery at this time, and the authorities have not logged also any untoward incident and confiscated only minor sharp items. As of 12 noon, there is no crowd estimate yet for all 21 cemeteries of Cebu City. But here in Careta alone, we were told that some 1,500 to 2,000 individuals already came to visit their departed loved ones. In this cemetery, there are about 15,000 individuals buried here, including those who suffered during the ill-fated MV Princess of the Stars years back ago. And the authority said they will continue to monitor all 21 cemeteries in Cebu, including 13 cemeteries located in the mountain barangays of this city. And that's the latest here from Cebu. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.